Good morning, my brothers and sisters, and welcome to Santa Cruz Catholic Church. We respectfully ask at this time that you silence your cell phones for the celebration. And we ask that all children be accompanied by adults when they go out into the courtyard. Since we have no music, we will recite the entrance antiphon. So the opening antiphon, the entrance antiphon, is found at the bottom of page 4. If you, O Lord. A few announcements. The celebrant is Father Showri. We are praying the novena to St. Therese, the child of Jesus. That's her statue over there. Most likely we will pray the novena prayer after the intercessions. So there are copies of the novena prayer by the door over there and by the door over here. Also, it is in your bulletin, so you can, either way, you can get a copy of your novena prayer, and we'll pray that after the intercessions. So we'll begin momentarily. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But with you is found forgiveness, O God of Israel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all and with your spirit. Dear brothers and sisters, as we gather here in the holy temple of God in the presence of the Father, let us call to mind the times that we were failed to be grateful to Him, the times that we fail to be thanking Him for the blessings that we have received. Ask God's forgiveness and pardon for those moments before we enter into this celebration in a worthy manner. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. Naaman went down and plunged into the Jordan 7 times at the word of Elisha, the man of God. His flesh became again like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean of his leprosy. Naaman returned with his whole retinue to the man of God. On his arrival, he stood before Elisha and said, "Now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Please accept a gift from your servant." Elisha replied, "As the Lord lives, whom I serve, I will not take it." And despite Naaman's urging, he still refused. Naaman said, "If you will not accept, please let me, your servant, have 2 mule loads of earth, for I will no longer offer holocaust or sacrifice to any other god except to the Lord." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord has revealed to the nations His saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for He has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for Him, His holy arm. The Lord has made His salvation known. In the sight of the nations, He has revealed His justice. He has remembered His kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song. Sing praise. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David. Such is my gospel, for which I am suffering, even to the point of chains, like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I bear with everything for the sake of those who are chosen, so that they too may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus, together with eternal glory. This saying is trustworthy. If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. 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 In all circumstances, give thanks, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Through the words of the Gospel, may our sins be wiped away. Amen. Good morning. Hope you're all doing well. Right? So? It's a beautiful weather. Nice. So you should be happy. Praise God all the time. There was a young boy. What is your age? 18, 13, 12 and 13 years old, little John, right? I don't know, he's your not John, name is John. So he was, you know, he's a, just entering into the teenage, right? Teenager. You know how the teenage boys and girls, right? They're very obedient, very humble, right? Yes. So one of these kids went to the seashore. He saw a pier, right? He went on it. There was also the adults were standing on that, looking at the ocean and having fun. And he slipped and fell in the ocean. And immediately it was noticed by a sailor also was there, right, walking around on that pier. So he jumped. He jumped, and finally after struggling 1 hour, 30 minutes, he brought him back. Okay, he survived. He saved. And then, you know, once it's happened, people gather there, right? People gather, and then finally the parents came, they took him home. I think after 2 days, the mother came back to thank him, right? And said, "Mister, thank you so much for saving my son." But she was so mad. "Where is his hat?" "He was wearing very costly, expensive hat. Where did you hide it?" "Go into the deep ocean, find it." "No, I'm just kidding." She was asking, demanding for the hat instead of thanking him, grateful to him for the saving of his son's life. Dear brothers and sisters, the readings today the Mother Church presents to us and trying to remind us that we need to be grateful to God at all times. All the time, we need to be grateful to God for the abundance of blessings that He is showering upon all of us. That's what the readings are, all of them, trying to tell us, teach us today. The first reading, Naaman is the highest in commander from Syria, at present Syria, but earlier in the past it was called Aram, the kingdom of Aram. He was affected with the leprosy. Olden days, the leprosy was considered was a terrible disease. There's no cure, like let us say, the stage 4 cancer, right? No healing. And the severity is like 2020, the month of April. What was it about? 2020 April, COVID lockdown, right? And how everybody was feeling. If somebody coughs, runs away, everybody running away, right? And somebody sneezes, oh my goodness, that's gone case, running away. It was the same situation. The people who gets the leprosy, the people also run away if they see them in the society. That was the situation. But Naaman, being a highest in commander, he was hiding, right, with all that. So, and he was suffering, and if he was searching for everywhere to get healing, to find a healer around the world. I'm talking about centuries back before Christ. So nobody found it. No one can heal this deadly disease, leprosy. So finally, he gave up. Maybe he's having some hope. So, but fortunately, The slave girl of Naaman's wife, the girl was working, and she heard finally about his master's disease, and she said, There is a healer in Samaria. So go and get him, and then he will be able to heal him. This girl is a slave girl captured from Samaria when this king of Aram invaded the Samaria. They captured all of them and they brought them to Syria. So that's how it was worked. And then Naaman immediately went to the king and said, there's a prophet, the healer in Samaria, who can heal my disease. And then he said, okay, I write a recommendation letter, go. So he went there with that letter. The king was so upset and sad, blaming himself. Am I a god? What am I going to do? Am I able to make somebody die, somebody alive? No, I can't do it. And he tore his clothes and weeping and lamenting, heard by Prophet Elisha, and told king, send him here, I will take care of him. So Naaman went to Elisha. And then the story was very interesting, the today's gospel context, if you remember the reading, first reading, right? So he was in the chariot, sent two servants to Elisha, tell him to come out and pray for him so God can send his blessings from heaven. Elisha did not come out. He just sat inside and said, go and tell your boss, go to the river Jordan and wash himself seven times, clean himself seven times. He was so mad. I am a highest in commander. This is only a healer, and he couldn't come out even when I asked. And moreover, he asked me to go and take wash in that dirty river. Don't we have in Syria, don't we have greatest rivers? The very strong rivers, purified clean water rivers. Why am I supposed to take in this one? And no, I'm not happy. And then he was leaving almost. And his servants begged him to go. What do you lose if you go and wash yourself? That's all you're supposed to do, just do it. If it cures, best. If not, he's not going to worse than you right now at the present situation, right? So he went and washed. First time, second time, third time, he dipped himself in the water. Fourth time, fifth time, sixth time, seventh time, he washed. Look, his skin became like a little child, glowing, fresh. And immediately he found out everything was cured and normal. And he ran, thanking God of Yahweh, God the Father, and thanking the prophet, saying, there is no God in this world except the God of Israel. And praise and glory his name all the time. And he commanded all his servants to give Elisha the precious jewels, golds, and diamonds, all that as a gift. Elisha said, no, I don't want any. Just be thankful to God. So that's why we heard the response to the psalm. The God has revealed to the nations his saving power. God has revealed his saving power, the power to the nations, to other nations. They are coming from all the way from Syria, right? The other country, pagan country. So God showed. And then you know what Naaman did? Because he's not receiving any gifts, he said, sir, master, allow me to take some soil from this place, and I go take it to my country and make it an altar and do my thanksgiving sacrifices on the altar to God, our Heavenly Father, all the time, every single day. Elisha said, okay, take it. So he took it. So the story continues. Go and read if you have time. The second book of the Kings, chapter 5. There was also interesting follow-up, if you are able to read it. Very interesting stories. The foreigner received the power of God, the grace of God, and he was thankful to God and grateful. In the same way, in the gospel, out of 10 lepers, only Samaritan came back to Jesus, realizing that he was healed. The same leprosy got healed. And then he was thankful to God, prostrating himself. And Jesus is very clear in saying, "10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? And Jesus, the rest, "Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" So, we know our God, he expects the gratitude from us. The blessings that he's been showering upon us doesn't make anything for him. If we give thanks to him, it doesn't make any difference for him. Right? You won't become fat or you won't become lean. Nothing. Just he wants us to be grateful for the blessings that he's been showering. Brothers and sisters, how many blessings that we have been receiving every single day in our lives? Don't we? No? Some of you are doubting. Yes, brothers and sisters, whether you say yes or not, that is the truth. So many people died yesterday without seeing a day, today, the sun. There is no another day for a few people, for many people in their lives, but we all have that day. We are able to wake up and see the light, right? Have a nice breakfast and we are here. Which means that's a grace. That's a blessing. That's a God's blessing that we are receiving every single day. How many of us really thank God early morning when we wake up, when we are able to open our eyes with the life? How many of us really say thanks to God? Thank you, Father, for giving me another day. How many of us really say that? Good. Some of you are nodding your heads. You better do it. Otherwise, you don't know. The day will come, you won't see the day. Right? You won't see the day. Always be grateful. And the many blessings, we have enough to eat. I know we're all struggling. We are all suffering. No, we are all having problems and difficulties, issues in our families, in our lives. But one way or the other, we are able to eat, we are able to wear clothes, and we have a shelter to live. Right? So there are so many who's lacking all of them. There are people dying, not even a meal for a week. No water. So comparing to them, how many blessings that we have been receiving? So many. There was a lady recently in the hospital. All the organs of the body failing one after the other. I went to see her. The family was crying and weeping. This part is okay. She was able to, the mind, everything is working. She is able to talk, right? She's able to talk clear. But the whole body was not functioning. It's already gone, control. And everybody was crying when I went to bless. She was so happy. "I thank God for giving me this life." Who say that? And I heard the story the other day, when I was reading. The same situation. She was failing all the organs, everything, even she lost the sight, she lost hearing. One of her niece came to visit her And still, there's a smile on the face. Aunt, why you are still smiling? You are going to die. I am still smiling, my dear. So, I am grateful to God for that. And what if not? Still, I am grateful to God because you are here for me to see me. How nice, huh? How beautiful is that? So we need to be grateful to God. In all our problems, in all our difficulties, He will show multiple blessings upon us. He will shower. Who will receive them? No matter what, we always be grateful to God and grateful to one another. We all know that three magical words, right? No? Yes. Thanks, please, and sorry, right? We say 100 times one another, thank you for everything. But we forget to thank God at the same time. Every blessing we receive. So the Eucharistic celebration, Eucharist is Eucharistia, a Latin word, means thanksgiving. Nothing else, right? Thanksgiving. So every Eucharistic celebration is a thanksgiving celebration. We are all here to thank God for all the blessings that we have received, especially the sacrifice that He did for us and the grace that He's going to shower upon us. So we are grateful and thankful to Him. At the same time, we seek the blessings for the future life too. So don't forget that. So let us continue to realize the blessings to us that God showered us, and we continue to give glory and gratitude. Amen. Please rise. Let us together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty. Consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us man and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life everlasting. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, gathered as one to celebrate the good things that God showered upon all of us, let us ask Him to prompt in us prayers that are worthy of His hearing.
For the Church, that the world of God may never be chained in her assemblies, but that the salvation that is in Christ Jesus may be proclaimed by her holy apostles and preachers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the nations and their leaders may come to realize, as Nahum did, that there is no God in all the earth except the one who has revealed Himself in the history of Israel, and that they may give Him their worship and obedience. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For grateful hearts, that we may bring to Jesus our most humble thanks for His blessings and never take any of His goodness for granted in our lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of strong faith, sufficient to draw down the power of the Lord in our lives and in the lives of those we love, that we may attract His grace and help in every need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose suffering or sickness may have made them outcast like the lepers in today's readings, that our compassion and prayer may reach out to our Jesus to for them to obtain gifts of healing and joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of our relatives and friends who have gone before us, and especially Adrian Pagan and Carmen Rodriguez, for whom this Mass is offered, that they may all rest in the eternal peace of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pause for a moment in silence and present to our Heavenly Father the petitions we carry within our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us. May your mercy beseech you, O Lord. Be with your people who cry to you, so that what they seek at your promptings they may obtain by your ready generosity. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And at this time we'll have the novena prayer. All of you have that? Heavenly Father, we thank you for the wisdom you gave us through your beloved Saint Teresa of Jesus. Her life was a holy example of prayer, sacrifice, and faith in you. We humbly pray for her intercession. Saint Teresa, we know that you are a powerful intercessor because of your close relationship to Jesus and Mary. Open wide the doors to the interior castle of our souls, so that we may know how to pray. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. Humble spirit and contrite heart, may you be acceptable as a sacrifice in your sight this day, be pleasing to you, Lord God. The washman will be blessed for my sins. Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim: Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, saving passion of your Son, and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all your saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the praise of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. May this be in the memory of Lord Jesus Christ, bring to life to us, so to say. Agnus Dei, vitolis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, vitolis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, Vitolis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Amen. The communion antiphon is the second option. When the Lord appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. So here are a number of announcements which you can find in the bulletin. Saturday, October 15th is the Solemnity of St. Teresa of Avila. So please join us at the 8 a.m. Mass. It is that time again, calling out all golfers to the 16th annual Father Bach, Brother Angel de Santa Cruz Benefit Golf Tournament on Saturday, October the 22nd. So please call the office if you have any questions. Come join us for our Trunk or Treat event on Saturday, October 22nd at the school field from 4 to 8 p.m. We will have concerts, prizes, car shows, food, and much more. And also join us on Friday, October 28th for our school Halloween carnival from 6 to 9 p.m. The Guadalupano bilingual group meets every Monday at 6 p.m. in the Capilla de Guadalupe. So come and pray the rosary. We have spiritual talks. Every first Friday of the month, we'll have Holy Mass and benediction. The Pima County Youth One Stop is hosting an event for employers hiring youths aged 16 to 24 on Wednesday, October 19th from 1 to 4. Please call the parish office for more information. Last announcement, and I'll get off script. The Eucharist catechesis, our first Eucharistic workshop in July, was very well received, so it's time to have our second Eucharist catechesis. So the first one was really well received. Everybody that went really said that they benefit greatly from it, understanding more the Eucharist and deepening their devotion to the sacrifice of the Mass. Sally, our Eucharistic minister for this morning, actually came from that workshop, and this is the third time that she serves. But again, this is not just solely for Eucharistic ministers. It is for all of us. So all of you are invited to this so that you can learn more about what the Eucharist really means and the importance it lies in your family. The bishops have asked for a Eucharistic revival, and this is part of the revival movement. So this is Saturday, October the 29th, at the end, the last Saturday of October, at the Capilla at 8. So all of you are invited for that. Thank you.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go and glorify the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God. Happy Sunday. Good. God bless you.